Table of Mundane Podcast. One show rises from the ashes. Critics are calling it outrage. As we know, never be the same again. Tonight, prepare for an epic journey. Last in a place and show. The mission? To rise above the rest. The danger? Unimaginable. The reward? A shit ton of weed and laughs. It's going to blow your mind. This is To Be Blunt. So turn up the volume. Grab your weed, get ready to light those blunts. Is scheduled for one fall. We are back to Be Blunt Podcast episode 20, the Coquito Podcast. In studio, we got Frank Knox. Hell with a Frank.
Yo, what up, podcast world?
We got High Voltage Omar here live at studio all the way from New York. Say what up, High Voltage.
What's up, everybody?
And of course, the Scott late seat empty. Fucking jabroni right here, you know?
No wonder why him and Tim are friends. They're late, you know, everywhere.
I can't believe it. You know, we tell the guy 6 o'clock every week, and he shows up late, you know?
Unacceptable.
But whatever, it doesn't matter. We got a huge show today. We got another edition of Gas or Trash, which is going to be great. We got the artist Das from Connecticut, who submitted a track for Gas or Trash. We're going to play that today, and we're going to let you guys vote if it's Gas or Trash. You already know how it goes. We're going to play Stump the Scott if this jabroni ever gets here. Because, you know, Scott's about 50-50 right now in his games.
He's terrible. Maybe he's studying. Maybe that's why he's late. He's getting those last-minute cram session of trivia knowledge.
I hope so. Which, by the way, we're going to have new rules here. It's only going to be WWE because, obviously, this guy cannot, you know, do anything else.
No. Even the WWE has been dropping the ball.
I know. Well, if you want to call in Stump the Sky, 603-847-110, whenever he gets back in the studio, we'll play Stump the Sky. We got weekly news, whole bunch of news from this week, and of course, a very personal, very exclusive, very unfiltered interview with my man, Omar, here live on the 2B Blunt Podcast. How's it going, guys? Are you ready? Episode 20. We made it 20 freaking episodes, Frank.
I can't believe it.
We started this show. It was just the two of us.
I thought that, you know, they were going to come knocking on the door to shut us down with, you know, the way we get lit up in this studio.
Some jabroni tried knocking on my door last night.
Oh, really?
Dude, I'm sitting home. I just got back from the gym. I'm lighting up. I'm eating some food. And all of a sudden, this fucking no good jabroni starts knocking on my door.
What the fuck did he want?
So I'm smoking. I get paranoid. I'm like, maybe it's the cops. Because I always get people to come over and they're like, yo, you could smell from outside. So I'm like, shit, maybe the cops are here. So I let that shit run. They knock. They knock again. They knock again. I go in the bedroom thinking maybe they'll go away. I'm trying to hide. The guy keeps knocking.
Turning lights off.
Dude, I swear to God. So he wouldn't stop. The dogs are going nuts. So I'm like, you know what? Let me see who this fucking guy is. I open the door. It's this fucking Wesleyan-looking kid talking about saving the water from chemicals.
What?
Trying to get me to donate cash.
What? Donate cash?
Oh, yeah. So I end up cutting a promo because he literally knocked on my door for probably like 8 minutes, bro. 8 minutes. This guy kept knocking, and I wouldn't answer. He didn't get the hint. And I was like, dude, what if I had a child sleeping or some shit? It's 8:30 at night, and you're knocking on my door.
Looking for cash donations.
Yeah, yeah. And one, and not only that, you want me to write letters to Ned Lamont, to my local representatives.
Wow, so you opened the door and actually let this guy say what he needed to say.
Well, no.
I'm surprised you opened the door and say, shut the fuck up and close the door.
He kept trying to cut me off, bro. You're trying to cut me off.
Wow.
I was pissed. Here I am thinking the cops are knocking on my door. I'm over here getting ripped. You know? It's fucking bullshit.
So did you give a cash donation?
Fuck no.
Did you write a letter?
No. The guy's like, you got a working printer? I'm like, fuck you. Throw a working fucking printer.
What do you want? Snacks, a cup of water?
Yeah, that's right. You want a snack, bro?
You got some H2O in the house? Some Chex Mix?
Well, we don't have any H2O. We got some HVO right here.
That's right.
So before we get any further, we got something to do. And that's the ceremonial lighting of the blunt right here in the studio with special guests.
I've been waiting for this all day, man.
Me too. So before I go any further, I ask you both, are you ready?
I'm ready.
I said, I'm ready too. Oh, it's about fucking time that Scott's here. Wow. What's up? And it's fucking the repair jacket.
Yeah, you know he had to work. There's a worker in the studio. He's like, I gotta impress him.
He's gotta impress him. He's got the repair gimmicks. The Scott.
What's up, bro?
What's up, Scott? Got your new setup over here. Let me turn your mic on. Rudy's about to light the blunt. But you rudely interrupted me.
I know. I'm delaying the lighting of the blunt. Let's go.
All right. Like I was saying, are you ready?
Scott's ready for that bottle of water.
Let's go.
All right.
Uncapped.
I said, are you ready?
I'm ready.
We're ready.
Then, for the four of us in this podcast studio, and the hundreds listening at home and watching live on the Facebook stream, let's get ready to smoke it. Tell him, Frank.
And if you're not down with that, we got two words for you.
Smoke it! That's right. We got kick pops loaded. We got the drinks popping. Scott's trying to get set up. You showed up on time, wouldn't have had this problem, damn it.
Listen, it wasn't my fault.
We want to blame it on Walmart?
We'll blame it on traffic. We'll blame it at work.
Fucking Walmart Scott. Walmart Scott. Just 95.7's got Walmart Jeff. We got Walmart Scott. You know?
At least our Scott, our Walmart works at Walmart, you know?
That's true. Very true. Scott, how do you like the new setup?
Dude, it's beautiful.
You don't even have to talk into the mic as crazy anymore. You can just leave it right there.
Yeah, it's beautiful, man.
That's it. You know? So you're good. Everyone's good. Everyone's set up. We got the blunt lit. And this is where it's at, man. I have been waiting all day to smoke this goddamn blunt.
Smells good. Man. It smells delicious.
Yes, that's right. Strain of the week. What are we smoking on? I'm sure that's what you're wondering. I'm going to tell you. Right here in this blunt, we got sour gelato.
Wow. Smells,
sour gelato.
Smells really good.
Sour gelato is gelato number one crossed with Ken Dog and sour diesel. So you already know that is high grade potency right there. Sour gelato, also known as gelato 33, appears to be an Oregon bread, positive mood inducing, clear-headed and energetic, yet also calming, 50-50 indica sativa hybrid. The citrus, grape, and earthy strain often elicits hunger. So by the end of the podcast, we're calling Domino's. Don't be fucking surprised. Because it's going to be going down. Frank, what do you say? You want to take a hit of this?
Oh, I'm ready for a hit of that, for sure.
Man. But make sure if you're listening, you subscribe, you review the podcast. Make sure you're checking in. We're on the live feed on Facebook. Frank telling me that it's all set. So that's what I like to hear. We're running good. Make sure you guys want to call in. The phone number's right on the fucking screen. 860-384-7110. If you're listening, you want to call in, you want to talk to HVO, you want to try to stump the Scott, whatever it might be, that is the number. Please call in. We highly encourage it. It's going to be a hell of a show. What'd you guys do over the weekend, yo? I barely feel like I talked to you guys since last Thursday.
I went to the Battlefront show with you on Saturday.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. We trekked up to Ludlow, Mass, and we stepped in there styling and profiling. Got the new Impact players. It's pretty sick. And then that was it. I mean, that was, as far as the weekend goes after that, that was it. That was it about you, Scott.
Man, listen, working in retail this time of year, I get stuck at work. That's why I missed your show, man. So that's all I did, really, was work all weekend.
That's all you did.
The most exciting thing I did was I did a beer trade.
A beer trade?
A beer trade.
Where it's almost like a drug deal, man. You meet somebody somewhere in a parking lot, and, you know, I got some beers that you want. He had some beers I wanted, and, you know.
You get some broken skulls?
That's how it works. No, I have broken skulls. I don't need to trade for those.
What a fucking Scott. I figure you got the Stone Cold gimmicks.
I got them before they were available here.
Showed up in his Ribera jacket. And all he's missing is the fucking Stone Cold beers.
I need the Zubaz and the fanny pack, though, to go with it.
That would have been it. You would have been set. What about you, bro? You doing anything exciting this weekend?
Yeah, I got my NYCW championship back from Waino.
Yes! Yes! That's what I'm talking about.
That's right. That's right. It's I've been doing, right? Bringing the championship home.
The belt comes back.
It came back. It's with me right now in my book bag. It wanted to come along with, for the trip. To say no?
We got the title right here in the studio.
Championship gold in the studio right now.
That's what I'm talking about. Oh, he's going to pull it out. He's going to pull it out. We're live on the Facebook. You got the... Oh, my God. Look at that. Look at that.
Pull it out.
Wow.
When they say pull it out, we pull that out.
That's right.
We pull it out.
We always pull it out, damn it. We got the gold, baby. We got the gold right here in the studio. And it's going to be great. It's going to be great. You know what? This whole past week. Now, Scott, I don't know if you remember last week. We talked about Chick-fil-A. Not to change the topic because the gold's beautiful. We talked about Chick-fil-A and Popeyes.
That's right.
You know, we put up a poll.
That's right.
Online.
We got some results.
We got results. Frank, do you want to deliver the results?
Sure, I'll deliver the results.
We asked our audience, what was the better sandwich? Chick-fil-A or Popeyes? Now, the Scott said the Popeyes was nothing to be raving about.
Right.
Even though the people get stabbed over it.
Not worth stabbing anybody.
I've never had either or. HVO, have you had a... Any of these?
No, none.
Me neither.
Nothing.
Okay, I'm not the only one.
You haven't had Chick-fil-A?
No.
I've only had Chick-fil-A.
So. I've never had Chick-fil-A or Popeyes.
I've had Popeyes. Where I used to live in Troy, New York, there was like one around the corner. But
you never had the
sandwich. No, not the chicken sandwich. Yeah. No chicken sandwich.
I've had like the ripping chicken.
Yeah. Like the occasional $5 specials that it had.
Exactly.
Yeah, hell yeah.
So, Frank, what was the results of this poll here?
So, the results of the poll were Chick-fil-A ended up being voted the better sandwich, 11 votes to 4.
Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A comes out on top.
I believe it.
For a sandwich with steamed bread, butter, pickles, and chicken.
Which sounds gross.
What's special about it?
I don't know. You want to talk about some shit? I seen a picture today from this guy.
Yeah.
The Scotty. Popeye's chicken, but dipping it in the Chick-fil-A sauce.
So let me tell you the backstory on this.
Oh, though. God, there's a backstory.
So, I'm trying to eat healthy, right, with our whole Edge Fitness challenge and everything, right?
Which ends today.
I did eat healthy today, but then I come back into the office, and my coworkers, they got Popeye's. I was like, oh, you got nobody asked me for any?
Then
one of my coworkers, she doesn't finish all her food all the time, and I was like, fuck it, I'll take it. But there were no more sauces. And one of the other managers, I know she's got like a drawer full of Chick-fil-A sauces. So, yeah, I don't know if it's like a sin or not, but I dipped my Popeye's chicken in Chick-fil-A sauce.
So the backstory just ate the scraps of one girl and used sauce of another woman.
Yeah, I guess that's pretty accurate.
All right, great.
Wow. Okay. 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 Damn. It's like that. It's like that here in the studio. Well, I guess that's it.
I would have done the same thing. Who am I to judge?
I don't know, but the breaking news, your winner, Chick-fil-A.
I'm not surprised, because you can go to Chick-fil-A and get the fucking sandwich. You go to Popeye's, you risk death, and you're probably not going to get the sandwich either.
This is also very true.
I'm going to tell you right now, though, I think the KFC, like Nashville Hot, I think that's better than both of them.
What?
I've what, the little mini sandwich?
The Chicken Little?
Well, if you want to get a Chicken Little, but you can get a bigger size, too, but I'm telling you, that Nashville Hot. That's what she said.
Not a fan. Not a fan.
Man.
If anyone else wants to, you know, talk about what their favorite chicken sandwich is, feel free to call in.
That's right. Phone number's right on the screen. If you're not watching on Facebook, call in 860-384-7110.
Now, what are you pouring lean over there?
Nah, bro. So, you know, yeah. First off, this is episode number 20, Scott.
Wow, the big 2-0.
We made it to the big 2-0. We have dubbed this show the Coquito Podcast.
All right.
That's right.
All right.
I saw that on your live feed.
So I got here.
On your live feed earlier this week.
I got four cups, you know, a little taste test. And what we're going to do is we're going to drink some Coquito. And I even got by request the cinnamon to sprinkle
Coquito
right into your shit.
All right.
So I'm going to let the man with the Coquito, let's get this thing popping, bro. What do you say?
I don't know if you guys are ready, though.
We're fucking ready, man. This is the 2B Podcast.
Ready.
Are you sure you're ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
I think we're ready. So, let's get ready to drink it. That's right, baby. Coquito. We don't mess around here. 2B Blood Podcast. He's pouring up. This is homemade, by the way. In case anybody's questioning the validity of this. This is homemade.
We're just going to do a little bit.
That's fine. We'll sip throughout the show, as I like to say. We're going to sip. Like I do with these beers that Scott brings in because they're so fucking heavy. We sip them, you know? Anyways, we got 2B Blood Podcast.
Whew. So, yo, what's in this Coquito? What's the ingredient?
Oh, okay. There you go, Frank.
What are we drinking here?
Down here.
It looks like eggnog.
A little cinnamon for those who want a little sprinkle. Yeah, what do we got in here? The base ingredients. Yeah, like basic ingredients. If I wanted to make this tomorrow, what would I need? I'm clearly white as fuck. All right. So you got to walk me through this.
I think he's Googling it.
Oh, no. No. What do you mean you're Googling it?
I have a feeling he's Googling it.
Wait a second.
I see a lot of, you know.
Wow.
I mean, I Google it too, but I don't even know how to spell it.
Well, Scott.
Well, he made this.
That's like you Googling treehouse shit, you know?
Well, it's just
what, do you wing it?
Yeah, it's a regular Coquito recipe that I found online, and I just adjusted a few things, you know, added just a little bit.
Oh my god, it's
more
so good.
This and that. And mostly the alcohol that I like rum, I like bourbon.
That's all stuff I like very much.
That's good.
It's just a little bit of adding a little bit of this and that, and it's mostly the only special thing about it is the alcohol that's in there.
Isn't there like some eggs, like some type of like Goya egg?
There's like a coconut cream, I think, in here.
You say Goya eggs?
Goya. Yeah, like
this. Goya?
Like
Goya.
What? Goya.
Goya. It's Goya. Goya and eggs, bro. I looked it up.
Oh, Goya and eggs. I thought you said Goya eggs.
Goya brand eggs. So, yeah, I've heard of that like shit. Goya in a
can. You know those shits are yellow.
It's like Goya in a can.
Got them yellow eggs, yo.
Eggs are supposed to be yellow.
Oh, my God.
You got the yolk.
Oh my god, we're getting crazy here. So listen, we're gonna do, before I get any further, Frank, how's the Facebook feed? You got any comments? Any users commenting in? What's going on over there, bro? I can't check no more, so I need you to report in on this.
We got comments.
What do we got?
We got you know, Paul Ferrari calling the Scott secondhand Scott.
Oh my god.
We got Bob Thorpe, you know, asking where Slade Dangerfield is.
I'm fucking right here, bro.
And you got Mario Marcelino still saying Kenny Omega is the son of none other than Tom McGee.
You know what?
We might have to run a paternity test.
It's promo time here. Mario Marcelino, if you're watching right now, all right?
He needs to come in.
You want to keep talking this topic, we'll discuss this theory you have.
We'll go roundtable discussion.
Roundtable discussion. We'll bring in Mario, and we'll talk about this theory. Kenny Omega, you know? Is the son of who?
Tom McGee.
Tom McGee.
The legend. That's
right. The legend.
The lost tape.
The lost tapes, right. Right on the network, you can find it. All about Tom McGee. like the one match he had, you know? And listen, if that's what he wants to do, either call in or come in the studio. You know, every week he comments, but I don't see him do nothing about it.
I would love to discuss.
I'm calling him out right here, right now. If you got what it takes, you either come on the air or you call in and let's have this discussion.
Call.
That's right. If not.
No, today's all about having balls. Call.
That's right. Oh, yeah. Well, we got balls right here. You want to talk about balls? We're going to do a new segment here on the podcast. Right. Did you know, Scott, when I had started making music, you know, and rapping, whatever, what I used to do before I was writing my own shit, or before, like, you know, I was, like, you know, really into it, is I would take popular songs and I would turn them into weed smoking songs. All
right.
And make them all about weed.
I did not know this.
Okay. Oh, yeah. That's how I started. I would take, like, regular songs you'd hear on the radio and I would turn them into weed smoking songs one way or another.
So, in essence, kind of like Weird Al Yankovic, but you're yes. Weed Al Yankovic.
I'm like the Weed Al Yankovic. Ooh, wow, that's like one of the best things we got here. The Weed Al Yankovic segment. I like this. This might be it.
I think it should just be Weed Sal Yankovic.
Weed
Sal Yankovic.
How dare you use my government name on this podcast?
It's Weed Sal Yankovic.
Listen, it's Peezy or it's nothing. God damn it. How dare you, Weird Sal Yankovic.
Weird Sal Yankovic. Drop the weed. Yeah, there you go. Weird Sal Yankovic.
Listen.
We can poll the audience, see what they want us to call it.
Yeah, we're going to poll.
We got to figure out what we're going to call the segment, because I'm going to try to, you know, if we're not going to do a commercial that week, I would like to do a parody song.
I vote parodies featuring Weird Sal Yankovic live on
air. I like it.
Well, let's get into the first parody here on the show. It's a personal one I had just worked on. My first one back in who knows how long.
That's it. You're lacing the boots back up.
2B Blunt Podcast. I call this one Smoking the Loudest.
To the new phase. Whoa. coach. This WWE Golf Channel, PGA Tour, EA Sports Madden. You know what time it is. 2 Speed Blunt Podcast with my boys, Frank Knox and Peezy.
That's right. We're back to the Blunt Podcast. What do you think, Scott?
Dude, smoking the loudest. Yeah, that's the shit right there. Yeah,
smoking like the loudest, that baby. Great. That's that new shit. What do you think? HBO's that approved?
Yes.
Smoking the loudest? Yes. That's right. 2B Blunt Podcast. We are back live in studio. The Scott Frank Knox. High Voltage Omar. Let's give the audience, the listeners, a dose of their weekly news. That's right. Right here at the 2B Blunt Podcast newsroom. Peezy giving you all the best when it comes to the latest, the greatest, the breaking news. It is 2B Blunt. That's right.
That's right.
That's right, baby.
That's right.
That's right. So we're talking about Chick-fil-A and Popeyes. Well, let me tell you what. We're going to kick things off hot.
Stop talking about these guys.
No. Headline here, right here. This is no shit. Like, no bullshit. New York City man finds half-smoked joint in Popeyes chicken sandwich.
What?
Can you... Yes, exactly. That's what I said. Half smoked. Yeah. Just when you thought it was over. Between, you know, the racist lady being body slammed in the parking lot of one of the chain's locations. Employees caught making sandwiches over trash cans. And someone even fatally stabbed we talked about the other week. You think that these sandwiches were like crack cocaine, baby.
Man, they've stirred like this... craze.
That's it. Smoke it, sniff it, light it. That's all they do with this shit. I don't get it.
Over a fucking chicken sandwich.
Did he order a smoked chicken sandwich, though?
No, I don't think that. I don't think he ordered it smoked. I'm not even sure if that's an option.
Maybe that's their secret, a joint in every bite.
Maybe that's why people are going nuts for them. Maybe that's what it is. You think maybe they're just stuffing half-smoked joints in all their sandwiches, and then all of a sudden, you know, people start finding out, and they start telling their boys, and then everybody starts showing up. Because they get half-smoked joints. It's been
I would not fucking show up for a half-smoked joint.
I don't know. You know what?
When hard times.
That's right. Feeling like a drought.
You don't even know what's in that shit.
You want to
pass
the blunts in your ashtray, or you want to go get a half-smoked joint and a chicken sandwich?
And if you're waiting for one of those, I don't know. You might stab somebody that tries to cut you in line.
Wouldn't that ruin the taste of the sandwich? That ashy-ass
I don't know, man. So this dude shows up. He gets two sandwiches, a regular and a spicy one. Right? Halfway through one of the sandwiches, the joint roach falls into his lap. Now, he said he wasn't going to go to the press about it, but he claims that he was disappointed by the Louisiana kitchen's inadequate response to his complaint. So first off, this guy's clearly a narc, because he called and said, listen, there's a joint in my sandwich. Why would anybody ever complain about that? Why would anybody complain about that?
That's probably trash. Fucking stems and seeds.
That's probably right. You probably got some Reggie in there.
Stems and seeds. What is this?
And then, you know what? It gets better. It gets better. Next headline, right, I see, is another food and weed gimmick. And I don't know where these people are going, but I need the hookup, right? This man apparently got super stoned after drinking some McDonald's sweet tea. And I'm thinking to myself, okay, how the fuck did he do that?
He ordered number 420. That's what he did.
I guess so.
Only logical explanation.
But it wasn't just like that. See, what they did is he asked for extra lemon. And apparently he believes that was a code for cannabis.
What?
Since he found 3 bags of weed in his cup. He said he didn't know the bags were even in there until he was, and I quote, high as a kite.
Were they tea bags full of weed?
It never states, dude. So I'm thinking to myself, did he just start drinking?
The bag wouldn't seep through.
Right, right, exactly. If it was like a Ziploc, that's not happening. Yeah. You know? So I wonder if it was tea bags with weed, but that would still be kind of weird, you know? Sweet tea, iced?
I don't know. I went to McDonald's yesterday, tried to order tea with extra lemon.
What happened?
Just got regular tea.
That's fucked up, y'all.
Wait, did you get extra lemon at least?
Yeah, I got extra lemon.
So the guy claims he never had cannabis, which is why he didn't recognize the taste. But I'm sure he's had sweet tea before, right?
Yeah, but it's...
So you would think, like, okay, this tastes different.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. It's like me saying, oh, I've had a beer, but I've never had a beer. So if I taste it, I wouldn't be like, oh, what the fuck is this?
If you had
foreign taste, you've never tasted in your life.
Right, but if you've had sweet tea before, and you know how sweet tea is supposed to taste, mm-hmm. and then magically it's made with weed now, obviously, you would notice that that would be something different, you know?
He must have had that lemon.
And I don't know, man. I'm not getting this lucky, you know? And he didn't even have to pay extra for the weed, which is the bullshit part. So he got three bags of weed and a sweet tea. He didn't pay a goddamn thing extra.
So why is he complaining?
Listen, dude, people are crazy, man. People are crazy. I wish I knew. That's why this is the news. You know, the people around the world here, they're nuts.
So you
they're
shut nuts. Up and keep living.
Outside this studio, it's a fucking disaster out there. You know? Let's talk about celebrities. Yeah, fucking celebrities, all right? It's getting crazy. Miami Heat has suspended Dion Waiters after he reportedly ate cannabis edible on a flight. And then he went to, and had a panic attack. He freaked
mid-air,
out.
Midair.
He freaked out on the plane.
No.
Midair.
This doesn't shock me from someone like Dion Waiters, though. This
he's got a history. He's got a history.
He was supposed to be like the next big thing, and he's just been fizzled out. He's just on the weed, doesn't care.
Yeah.
And it's, I mean, but who the fuck panics over an edible?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. So they ended up giving the guy a 10-game suspension. Right, for this, because obviously a THC is a substance that's not allowed, right? So, I don't know. And the worst part is, like, it was the shortest flight. It was from Phoenix to L.A. It's literally a 90-minute plane. By the time you get to maximum height, you're descending again. You're up and you're down. It's literally, that's the flight. You know? Like, I don't know. I don't know. He claimed he had a stomachache the night before. He sat out for the game. Didn't play against the Phoenix Suns.
He sat out because he sucks.
Well, that's not what he says. That's not what they're saying. Although that might be true.
No, he was just dressing, but he wasn't playing. He was just sitting on the bench. He hasn't been getting burned over there at all.
He played a mean bench that night, though.
Yeah. I mean, that wouldn't happen to me. Maybe it would happen to you. You have anxiety, so I could see you doing that shit.
That would obviously be me. That would be me for sure. And then a funny story that you had sent me, Frank. It's about this Texas shelter cat.
Gangster of the year, bro. OG.
They had to place this cat in solitary confinement.
Yeah.
Yo, because this guy would keep going and letting the senior cats out. And they'd open the door. He'd jump and pull the handle down. And he'd open the fucking door all the time. No, I swear to God. I swear to God, Scott. You know? This guy named Quilty. This is what they call the cat.
Quilty.
You know? So they banished the guy into solitary confinement for this. You know? And of course, this cat has built a giant social media following.
Oh, dude, I bet you there's a waiting list. Like, they're interviewing people now to adopt Quilty, you know?
It's like
that whole shelter found a home.
Yeah, the IG's got like 30K, bro. 30K. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
For this fucking cat.
I mean, that's cool. That cat deserves what? It, man. He's a G.
That's what? Bro, G. We're a G, so why don't we got 30K? This is some fucking bullshit.
Because, you know, we're not in prison letting the prisoners out, you know? That's basically what he's doing.
This is insanity, bro. It's insanity.
Quilty.
Yeah. Quilty, right.
that's the cat of the year right there, bro.
It really is.
I don't like cats, but I would pet Quilty. You know I don't really like cats. I would pet Quilty.
You like Bruce, though.
Yeah, Bruce is cool.
You like Bruce. Cool.
The Dark Knight himself.
Yeah, exactly. So, and then we'll talk a little bit of wrestling because I know the Scott probably is going to feel left out this week. You know, due to the fact that instead of talking wrestling, we have a very special guest in the studio, which if you want to talk to
but
him.
He's going
to
be talking wrestling.
A6-0.
He's going to be talking the business.
I know, you know, but Scott like talk about his Vince McMahon, you know. Okay, Vinny Mac.
I don't need any more cinnamon, though.
Oh, we getting loaded up here?
Want some more?
We getting loaded up here? I don't know. WWE backstage this week. You guys watch it?
Nope.
I did not watch it, but I watched what happened. I watched the clip. I've seen the memes. I've seen the Scots crying. The Scots happy.
The Scots. You know. Listen,
I didn't even watch it live. Actually, everyone, I was in bed. Actually,
I see everyone talking.
I was in bed by 9:30.
Just to let you guys know what they're talking about, it is the epic return of one CM Punk.
Who?
That's right, Phil Brooks. I'm sorry, Phil Brooks.
Oh no.
You know, CM Punk. Shit. And he made his return after 6 years of being away from any kind of wrestling and a completely failed UFC.
Got his ass beat.
Mixed UFC. Martial arts career, yeah. Which was devastating to his career, if you ask me.
That ruined him. You know?
I tell you, I was talking to a friend of this podcast, and he was like,
"We got friends on this podcast."
What's he's like, whoa. "What about his UFC contract?" And I was like, "Dude, his contract ended the second he sucked wind in his last fight."
Yeah, he went the distance, right? He just got beat to shit. Yeah. He didn't get knocked out, but he took a beating like I haven't seen a lot of people take in my life.
Yeah, it was bad.
So we know Punk's back. He's on backstage, but he's not with WWE, right?
Well, that was already announced. I don't know why everyone's shocked. People talked about this 4 weeks ago that he was going to sign exclusively with Fox.
Right.
Now he comes back, and it's like the craze is happening
now,
again.
But now the door's open, kind of, right? So where does he end up? Does he have another match? Does he ever wrestle again?
I don't know. You're jumping. Listen, he's not even signed to Vince McMahon or WWE.
I think he'll wrestle again to fulfill that dream of...
What dream? He did everything.
Did he headline WrestleMania?
No.
No, he hasn't been in the main event spot, and that's like his big deal.
That's his dream, and that's his biggest beef besides getting fired on his wedding day.
Well, let's play the clip. CM Punk returning.
She's showing up for the
main event. We start doing some of our own right here on WWE backstage. You guys in?
Okay. Yeah,
all right.
Yeah, what are we doing?
In three, surprise. Two, one. Is this a rib?
And then he cuts like this stupid fucking promo that's like 10
you
seconds.
That's
right. Just when you think you know the answers, I changed the culture.
Wow.
Right? It was something like that, Scott.
It's as simple as this.
There it is.
When they think they got the answers, I change the culture.
Phil Brooks.
See you next week.
So he's not even signed to WWE.
He's signed to Fox.
He's only signed to Fox. People are already speculating. Oh, my God, he's going to get in the ring with Owens. He's going to get in the ring with all these different people. Styles, Daniel Bryan. And like even people are saying, what? Oh, now AJ Lee's going to come back, and AJ Lee's going to have some matches.
That's what they're saying.
But I think people are just jumping to conclusions.
If he comes back, I want to see him fight a stiff match with Triple H.
Wow.
But they fought
so many times.
They like hate each other.
Part of me really Punk would want to see Triple him H. If he wants to come back. Like I really would want to see him go to AEW. And I mean, whatever. He could probably make more money in WWE.
Why would you think he'd go to AEW?
That's not a possibility.
I say that is it would be amazing if he actually went while he's under the Fox contract. But I want AEW to stick around. Right, I don't want them to like they're having a boom right now, but I don't want them to be like TNA where they're just around forever and nobody gives a shit. Right, I want AEW to be on that same level as WWE or even higher. But Punk could definitely help them do that. Will it happen?
Probably it's not gonna happen, no. But you guys got like you know, there's gonna be guys like Sin Cara who quit.
Yeah, but they didn't like that. Didn't matter. Yeah,
Sin Cara could probably go to UFC and do better a job than Punk.
How are we talking about Sin Cara right now? You know?
Well, Scott was talking about AEW sticking around, and AEW's talent right now, they have nobody.
Yeah.
Introduce somebody this week that no one even knew who he was.
Speaking of the Scots, what really driving me nuts is all these Scots that are calling him sellout online. They're calling CM Punk a sellout because he's on backstage instead of working in the ring. These Scots have been chanting his name in arenas around the world for 6 years. And then he comes back and they go on Twitter and they wah. Like if we had Drolin Loud still, I'd be running the segment this week.
I'll tell you right now, the people that hate pro wrestling the most are pro wrestling fans. And the worst pro wrestling fans are CM Punk wrestling fans.
Well, you're probably right. You're probably right. Everyone's making a big deal about nothing. I think that it's great that he's back. Let him come back, do his thing. You know,
I think this opens the door.
Oh, I mean, of course it opens the door.
So people should just be patient and see what happens and stop. Just shut the fuck up.
That's right. I agree with that last part. Yeah.
That's a good point. All right.
And Rome wasn't built overnight. The dude's not going to just come back and be like, oh, I'm here. Statement. And it's going to be subtle. Exactly. Someone's going to come on backstage.
I'm here.
Piss him off. They're
going to
cut a pull on each other.
That's so
something's
true.
Something's going to happen.
I mean, there's a segment on the show just cutting a promo anyway.
And then, but there's going to be some violence or some tension, and it's going to lead to a WrestleMania that's going to feature CM Punk in his so-called dream of headlining WrestleMania.
Yeah.
So it's in the pipeline.
It's all right. All right. All right. That might be true. That might be true. But
what else is true?
We'll talk about AEW. I heard something from Chris Jericho that really blew my mind. He had talked about a time where Vince McMahon, he claimed, smoked weed in front of Donald Trump.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Listen. No, I'm dead fuck serious, Scott. He smoked weed in front of Donald Trump. He said, I remember one time Vince told me that they were watching some concert or something at Trump, New Jersey, whatever it was called, whatever the arena was called then, Trump Arena. And Vince McMahon was sitting there with Linda and all the heads of the state. And Vince lit up a joint. And Trump was like, that's right. He said, you can't smoke that here. You know how everybody just says this shit.
And he was like, shut up.
And Vince goes, stop. He goes, I just did. Straight up. So I was talking to Frank about this, right? Me and Frank were laughing. I'm like, well, what would happen if, like, today Vince still smokes and he's like, they say they're in California. And Vince wants to go pick up some weed for after the show. Got to make some phone calls, right?
You got to see what's out there.
What the fuck would that be like? So then, check this out.
WWE, Weed Wellness and Enlightenment. This is Jeremy. How can I help you?
Jeremy? This is Vincent Kennedy McMahon. I'm calling because I want to know what the top shelf herbs are for this week.
Excuse me, sir. We don't have top shelf herb. We only have top rope herb.
Top rope? I like the top rope.
Well, in that case, you're in luck, Vince, because this week we have many top rope, or what you would like to call top shelf herb. The first one being Kali Kush.
Kali Kush?
That's right, sir. Kali Kush.
Like the great Kali?
No, like the herb. The Kali Kush, sir. We have Kali Kush.
We have a great Kali right here at the WWE.
Wow. Well, then maybe you would like our Kali Kush. It gets rave reviews, and it's tall and strong.
I'll tell you what, I never really liked great Kali. He was a terrible worker. What else you got?
Well, one of my personal favorites is the Hunter Hearst Haze.
The what?
Hunter Hearst Hayes, also known as Triple H.
The Hunter Hearst Hayes? I know a guy by the name of Hunter Hearst Helmsley. What is this going on here? What kind of establishment are you running?
Well, sir, we are the WWE, Weed Wellness and Enlightenment.
No, I'm the WWE.
No, sir, you called me. This is the WWE, Weed Wellness and Enlightenment.
All right, you know what? What else do you have?
We also have the fan favorite, Guerrero Glue.
Guerrero? I know a lot of Guerreros. Which Guerrero is it?
The Indica, sir.
I don't know what you think this is. This is a joke. What is it, the joke? Hunter Hearst Haze? Guerrero Glue? I'm just looking for some regular flour. And you guys are over here ripping off all my gimmicks.
No, sir. We are an original farmer and smoke shop. I don't understand what you're trying to insinuate.
Yeah, what? You know what? You know what? Forget it. Keep going. What else you got? Give me something good. You got like a train wreck?
Well, we just got a new batch of the award-winning train wreck, which we call the A-Train wreck.
A-Train? You mean like that jabroni that used to run with X-Pac?
No, sir. He runs with the other plants that are in our greenhouse.
You know what? I think you're messing with me.
Sir, I can assure you that I'm not messing with you.
You know what? I'm going to give you one more chance to tell me what you have for weed. And stop stealing my gimmicks. Tell me, what is your top flower of the week?
Our top flower of the week is also our special of the week. So we're in for a real treat here,
all
sir.
Right.
We have the Stone Cold Diesel, and we're selling three joints for $16.
Stone Cold? Three Stone joints Cold for $16?
That's right.
How dare you? How dare you steal my ideas, my creativity, my business, my gimmicks? How dare you? I'm calling my lawyers right now. We're going to have a talk, me and you, in the courtroom.
Well, sir, I'm very sorry that you're upset, but I will sure let my boss know, Mr. Turner, that you're very upset.
You tell Mr. Turner that from here on out, I'm going to own his company, and he's fired.
I ain't never worried about no haters. I'm just sitting here trying to stack my paper. Keep it pushing, I will see you haters later. I'm just sitting here trying to stack my paper. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it, stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it, stack it. I ain't never worried about no haters. Trying to stack my paper. Keep it pushing, I will see you haters later. I'm just sitting here trying to stack my paper. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it, stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it, stack it.
Stack it up, I stack it. Pass the bowl so I can pack it on the street where I can pass it. Make some dough and go get blasted. I'm a king. Yeah, ain't that tragic, not a role model, a classic. I'm the real thing, you plastic. Hit the block, you can ask it, and they'll tell you that's the same thing. Oh, that Peezy, he's so clean. Riding round and making money, trying to do that rapping thing. Never gave up on his dream, and well, I just admire that. Plus, the CD is so bumping that you play it in the trap. Yup, it's too hard to believe, but I ain't gotta tell a lie. The shit I do is so damn cool, and plus, I get to play it live. A million people hear my music, thousands smoking on them sacks. Every DJ wanna play me, Peezy, let me get a track. Every artist wanna feature, who am I to go deny? Anyone who knows me knows I just wanna get high. 16, man, I go so ham, you think it was a meal. Throw a bag up on them stacks and then you got yourself a deal.
I ain't never worried about no haters. I'm just sitting here trying to stack my paper. Keep it pushing, I will see you haters later. I'm just sitting here trying to stack my paper. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it, stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it up, I stack it. Stack it,
stack it. This is Ty Shine, and you're listening to How to Talk. This is Ty Shine, and you're listening to How to Be Blunt with Peezy. This is Ty Shine, and you're listening to a new episode of How to Be Blunt with Peezy. This is Ty Shine, and you're listening to Be Blunt with Peezy. How in the fuck would you listen to anything else?
That's right.
I love him.
To Be Blunt podcast.
Oh, man.
We are back.
We back.
We back from commercial break.
Hey, we're about to get
hyped. That's right, baby. Yeah. That's right, baby. We're about to play Gas or Trash. You guys remember the rules. We're going to play you a track from a local artist, or actually any artist. It doesn't have to be local. Just hit us up on the podcast, you know, social media if you want to be part of. Oh, shit. We got a caller.
Well, we got to do the Gas or Trash.
That's right. You have to call back. We got Gas or Trash happening. So what we're going to do here is on the air, we have Das, a local artist from Connecticut. Say what's up, man.
What up?
Yo, what's up, Das?
That's what's up. Das, where are you from in Connecticut?
North Haven.
North Haven, yo. My pops live out there.
It's popping out there.
Yeah, I know, dude. I know. It's sick. Dude, so I've never met you before. So how long have you been doing music for?
Since middle school. I started out playing guitar and I played guitar too. Bands and progressed like into hip hop.
Every wrestler. Yeah, Das used to play the guitar in like a punk band, bro.
I was in a rock band.
When I met him, I used to work with him.
Really?
He was like,
y'all know each other like that?
Yeah, he was still.
Yeah. See, Frank, you didn't tell me that beforehand.
Yeah.
That's how he snuck him right in onto the show.
I've smoked with him. We haven't had any submissions, you know?
Yeah, no, that's great. So you said you've been doing this since middle school, right? So how old are you now, if you mind me asking?
28.
All right, so you've been doing this for a little bit.
19.
Yeah, 15, yeah. 15 years.
Sir. Wow, that's sick. And I'd say, like, what would you say would be, like, your defining moment then thus far? Because you've had, it's been quite a long career for you already now.
I don't know if someone says I played an open mic, actually, around this time last year, and that was, like, the first time I, like, stepped out of my comfort zone in a while. I'm actually trying to be back in that mode shortly.
Trying to get back into the live shows?
Yeah.
Dude, that's sick. It's me too, yo. I want to do a live show, Frank.
Yeah,
Peezy's maybe me and Dash should put together a show, bro.
Maybe you guys could collaborate on a track after about this, it. You know?
Yo, I'm saying.
You are the top producer in Connecticut, whether it comes to rap or podcasting.
This is true. That's true.
I've been flying under the radar for, you know, 15, 20 years.
I know. Well, yeah. You're right. You're right. It's true. It's so true. And I wasn't just flying under the radar, bro, though, you know?
Well, if for producing wise.
Oh, right. That's what I'm saying. I'm not going to talk about music. But this isn't about me. This is about Das. You know? Das, how would you describe your style?
I try to not have, I obviously have different influences, but I guess my style would be more like lyrical, conscious, you know, 90s like hip hop influence.
I saw that like 90s East Coast hip hop, the Nas's, the Jay-Z's, the
hell yeah. Yeah, nah, Wu-Tang. I feel that.
All right, I'm interested.
Wu-Tang. Yeah.
There we go.
The Root.
Right. We got HBO with the special guest interested. So you know we're on the right track here.
Yep.
You know? The Scott so far it looks like he's on the fence. Scott's on the fence.
I gotta hear it. I gotta hear the music.
Oh, Scott's gotta hear the gimmick. He's probably gonna do better than you do at Stump the Scott later. You know,
we'll see.
Damn, man. So, you have like a way that the audience can get, you know, contact you online or find your music? You have a website or anything like that?
Currently, I have a SoundCloud, and I'm in the process of getting up on other streaming services. But my SoundCloud is soundcloud.com/dasct. DASCT.
And tell me about the track we're about to listen to on the podcast here. That the audience is going to have to judge whether they think it's gas or trash.
It is written on some real, like, everything I write about is either something I've experienced or I can, like, relate to and try to hope other people could relate to some common ground.
All right. That's what it is. That's what it is.
Looking forward to hearing it.
I know. I'm looking forward to hearing it. Frank also mentioned to me that you could, you were pretty good at freestyling.
Yeah. Yeah, I got bars.
You got bars. All right. Listen, I don't like to do this all the time, but I got to hear this because Frank said that you had bars, and then Frank also apparently has bars, you know, because many of us have already heard, you know, for Frank's been, no. Oh yeah. Listen, that's right. Listen, I'm just saying. I'm going to pull the beat out. I don't know which one of you wants to start.
Yo, I'll start because I'm, you know, he's probably going to just dust me, but... Yo, it's the To Be Blunt podcast. Chilling with my man, PZ in the Blast. Got HBO, Coquito. Got Scott. Already know he's going to lose another round tonight. Me and PZ ain't looking for a fight, but we getting right. In the club every night, taking your honey and we gonna treat her right. That's right, that's how it goes. We smoke, and then we smoke some more. Sipping on Coquito, now I'm about to lay it down. And I'm gonna wrap myself like a burrito. Cause it's cold out, man.
It is fucking cold.
I wrap myself like a burrito when it's cold out, man.
Oh,
that's
shit.
All I got. All
right, let's hear what he's got. That's what he got for everybody.
Yeah.
All right. I know you really saw the struggle. I can see the struggle in the store, but couldn't move a muscle. I can see the promises tomorrow, but I'm losing hustle. I can see the time you have involved and your life is cut though. Times been tough through the rugged and rough. It got me steadily bugging and stressed enough to keep me questioning love. Intentions are sus, not to mention no prevention from the breaking of heart.
All right, okay, all right, all right. My man, all right. All right, listen, call in number 860-384-7110. We're going to play Das's new track, Fool Me Once, featuring Shiloh, right here on the 2B Blunt Podcast. Thanks for calling in, man.
Thank you.
Man, we had all those missed calls. Silence, life's been, but I see you all the time.
say you really did me dirty. And I don't wanna hurt no more. I don't trust a soul. I don't even flirt no more. It's clear we've lost control. Tried to make it work so far. We've only made it worse. These scars are covered by my shirt. Oh, my heart is all at work. I wish that I could remove it. Cause this hurt I've endured is the thing that's driving me stupid. Picked up the bottle and bottomed out. Didn't do shit, get back in touch with myself. All these discussions are useless. I'm not in love with myself. Gotta love myself through this. Say you was not like the. But that's what you is doing in the back of my head. And again, well, I ain't gone for this crap. I'm really packing this pen. Never see me lagging again. 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 Never see me lagging. Never see me lagging again. Never see me. Never see me lagging again. Said I've been new back, feeling inspired as ever. Looking back, yeah, we had a few laughs. We were tired and weather. Said I ain't gone for this crap. Every day I just try to do better. I've been living with my head in my bed. I'm really trying to find my true center. Said no regrets in this life. Each misstep is a lesson. I'm trying to learn to live right. So peace to every resentment. And peace to all those who doubt in me and want nothing to do with me. I can see the sun through the clouds. But really it's the rain that's been moving me. I'ma use this pain. Never see me lacking again. 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 Never see me lacking again.
Damn, 2B Blood Podcast, y'all was savage as fuck calling in.
Calling in nonstop, over and over and over.
Oh, man, I don't know if that's good news for DOS. I don't know if that's going to be good news. We'll find out. 2B Blood Podcast. Gas or trash. If you want to call in and tell God, here we go.
There it is.
Here we go. I'm not even going to lie. This is about to be nuts. 2B Blood Podcast, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Hey, my name is Jeremy, calling from Cahoes, New York.
All right. What's up, man?
All right. I want to talk to High Octane Omar over there. I'm a little upset with this guy. What? I hear he's going to be going against Fox Vineyard. Fox Vineyard's a really, really big dude. I don't think this guy's really going to do much against him. Mr. Suplex over here.
Are you kidding me?
He's going to get hit.
You're kidding me.
Beating Fox already.
Yeah, this guy's got more brains than Fox has hair.
All right.
Listen, don't talk about Fox's hair.
Listen, no, who said anything about hair?
Wait, who is this guy? Jeremy?
Jeremy.
The butt tender?
Jeremy's broken.
You guys need to chill out. All right.
Chill out. Who do you think you are?
Listen,
we are chill.
Octane Omar ain't got shit on Firework Fox.
Can you be a little bit more original when you try to make fun of my name? All right. 12 years in the business. All right. Come up with something.
You know what?
What?
Something better. It's better than your name right now.
Uh huh. What's your name? Jeremy.
Jeremy. Covered in electricity.
Jeremy, habla de cabrón que estoy cansado. Habla. Come on,
listen,
bro.
Listen.
I'm listening, but I you ain't speaking.
I bet that Coquito sucks.
Wow, that was great. Pat yourself on the back.
We got a regular old Barry Horowitz on the phone.
That's it. Hang on,
sentiment in there. There's no sentiment in there. I can't see shit. It looks like milk.
man. Dude, shit, what the hell's your issue?
So anyways, man, get to the bottom line of why you called. You suck.
You suck. You know what? I'll tell you what, buddy. I got nothing more than two words for you, and that's you can suck it. And that's how you get cut off, you bitch.
I can't believe that guy called that many fucking times.
Wow.
Who is this guy?
That must have been the same guy calling him. Whoever it is, they hate you.
I have no clue.
They hate you.
You really don't know who that was?
No, I have no clue. They hate you, bro.
Jeremy.
Wow.
Fox Vineyard's biggest fan.
That's right. Yeah.
Fireworks Fox Vineyard.
That's right. Fox Vineyard's only fan.
Oh. I just said that.
I'm only fucking around.
I just said that.
I like Fox Vineyard. He's a good dude.
We get along. If you've seen our matches,
listen,
we know each other in and out. We've gone back and forth.
I've done shows with Fox Vineyard before.
Man, I've never had
a problem with him. He's very good. I remember one time I got hurt and he was like, he kept checking on me, which is mad cool. So, I mean, dude's a good dude. But whoever the fuck me is, it's a piece of shit. And again, if y'all want to call in and tell us what you thought of that track from DOS, Fool Me Once, if you want to
gas it or trash it,
that's right.
You can reply.
Let us know, baby.
Let us know.
Call it in.
Hit on the comments, gas or trash.
That's right.
Call in.
How's the Facebook popping?
Everything's good.
Everything popping off.
It's popping.
It's popping.
We got some viewers.
Bart, we got some comments and shit.
Yeah, I've already read them all off, and there hasn't been really. I mean, High Voltage Omar has commented on it.
Well, speaking of High Voltage Omar, we're gonna call the Kincaid hotline quick, and when we come back,
oh shit,
that's right,
and John Kincaid.
When we come back, we're gonna talk an unfiltered, no holds barred conversation with High Voltage Omar. It's gonna be raw. More raw than Monday nights, baby. Right here on the 2B Blunt Podcast. But first, we got to call our boy, Don Kincaid.
Ladies and gentlemen, exclusive breaking news brought to you by the Kincaid Hotline. And now, renowned reporter, Don Kincaid.
It's Don Kincaid, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, exclusive breaking news brought to you by the Kincaid Hotline. And now, renowned reporter, Don Kincaid.
It's Don Kincaid!
Ladies and gentlemen, exclusive breaking news brought to you by the Kincaid Hotline. And now, renowned reporter, Don Kincaid.
It's Don Kincaid, baby!
That's right, Don. Me, Frank, and Scott got the minutes loaded up. I hope you got the dirt this week. It's been a big week in wrestling, baby.
Hey, baby, let's kick it, man. Don Kincaid, and boy, do I got some fun shit for you tonight, man. And I am going to jump right into something that's near to my heart. With a bet, and that is some Battle for Pro Extreme Massachusetts this past Saturday night. And the reason why I bring that up is because there was some historic shit that happened at Battle for Pro Extreme, and I know my man Peezy was present.
Yeah, I know all about that because my stomach still hurts from that kendo stick shot that Sandman gave me.
That was like an early Christmas present for me, baby.
Oh,
that
you think you're funny beautiful. Now, huh? You got jokes?
Ah, that was beautiful. Hey, but let me dig into that. We had three historic things that happened at Battlefront Pro Extreme. We had one, Ryan Fox, the hardcore champion for Battlefront Pro. He won against the Sandman. And yes, I did say the ECW legend himself, Sandman, and he was victorious, baby. And not only that, but after the match was done, who comes out but one Kev Mansur. Now, for those of you that don't know who Kev Mansur is, he is an athlete that has Down syndrome, and he has become the very first Down syndrome athlete to win the hardcore championship from one Ryan Frost.
Yeah, a short-lived championship run.
So I will have to follow up with that and say Mr. Frost came back out later on and won. Angel Sinclair did a little, you know, hoochie-coochie kind of distraction, and there is Mr. Frost for the roll-up in the 1-2-3 and the two-time Hong Kong champion, Ryan Frost.
That's right. The man who should be the champion.
And not only that, historic, I said, because the main event brought us one Dirtbag Dan versus one Len Oddity in a barbed wire match. They took the ropes down. They replaced it with barbed wire. That's the very first time in Western Massachusetts that has ever happened, and I would have wanted nothing more than those two guys. What a hell of a match.
That was hard to watch, Don. It was disgusting.
Lots of blood, lots of weaponry, but man, Len Oddity came up on top, and man, what a special match that was. I gotta say, blood or no blood, that was something to behold, and I am so glad that I was there to witness that shit.
I agree, it was one hell of a match. Mad respect to both those guys, Dirtbag Dan and Len Oddity, they killed it.
Man, it was insane. So, let me move on to the big boys here. We've got some the NWA news, because their very first pay-per-view called Into the Fire has sold out. And I mean, when I say sold out, there is 3 days of this. December 14th, 15th, 16th, all tickets, it's all in the theater. They are all sold out. Dude, this is going to be an insane weekend for one NWA. I got to say that.
I mean, that's big news for a company who just started putting out their own show like a month ago.
Dude, NWA has been on fire. I've been watching it. I love it because it's that little intimate studio feel, and you get that old school NWA vibe. I'm all about it, baby.
That's right. We talked about that last week on the show. I mean, they really have something special going on over there, you know?
Oh, hell yeah. But, I mean, this is not only happening in NWA. We've got one Danny Moss, one of the New England's top guys. He has now officially signed a 2-year contract with Ring of Honor, baby.
That's huge. That's huge. I mean, the man's a legend on the scene, you know?
Dude, his burning hammer takes every single person out like a flash, man.
Oh, you damn right it does.
So not only that, but we have one more big man to talk about, and that is one Josh Briggs. I've been putting my money on this big motherfucker since day one, and he is your new Evolve champion, one Josh Briggs, baby.
And that's big news for Josh Briggs. You know, another guy right out of New England, too. I mean, the guy's been making waves, and here he is, Evolve champion.
Dude, it's been insane. The ride watching him coming back from injury and doing his thing, the rise of Josh Briggs has been such a great ride for me because I've been following it since day one, man. He's been a joy, man. I love that guy.
Yeah, now look at him, champion.
Now, I want to move on to some MLW news. And boy, we were talking a while back about the Opera Cup. It has been 71 years since it has been, and I am telling you, it's going to be insane because it is going to be featuring 4 opening round bouts. And the league has invited some of the best wrestlers from around the world to compete in this one-night single elimination tournament. And MLW today, baby, has announced that the first match will be one TJP versus Brian Pillman Jr., baby. And that's December 5th.
Wow.
Yeah, man. That's going to be a fantastic match. I wish I could see that live, man.
Oh, me too. That's going to be wild.
Okay. I'm out of breath as it is, but I've been waiting. I've been chomping at the bit to get to this last bit of news, and it pertains to the WWE NXT brand. And just hours ago, hot off the motherfucking presses, oh, God, PG, wait for this one. ACH has officially quit NXT, but not only did he quit with a tirade of F-bombs in his car via cell phone, and I have his, oh man, I have his quitting, his resignation, if you will, right here, word for word. Can what? I read this shit, PZ?
Oh, please do. This is breaking news. I want to hear all about it.
All right, here we go. I hope I got enough breath. As of today, I officially quit fucking WWE.
Oh.
I am no longer employed. I refuse to work for racists. He paused before continuing with the video and says, I fucking quit. Fuck them. I hate their fucking company and everything they fucking stand for. All they ever did was hold our fucking people back. I do this for the culture. I do not need anyone's fucking permission to do... Wait. I lost it. I'm so excited. I do not need anyone's fucking permission to do what I want to do. Screw Jordan Miles. Don't ever call me by that slave name.
Whoa.
Call me ACH and don't forget the super, bitch. I quit. Fuck you. The end.
Holy shit, Don. You really think they're going to let him out of that contract? I mean, I thought they were holding everybody back.
I don't know because hot off the presses yet. Is one Sin Cara wants to be released, but there is word that they refuse to release him, and his contract isn't up until, get this, PZ, 2022.
Oh, no.
Could you imagine wanting to get out of the WWE, hating what you're doing, hating your position, and you still have to wait two whole years?
Damn, yo.
Whew. Oh,
damn.
God. That ACH boy, what a way to put in a resignation.
That's unbelievable. I mean, I can't believe it. He put that out in public for everybody to see.
Everybody to see, especially one Kennedy, Vincent Kennedy McMahon, and one Mr. Paul Levesque, a.k.a. Triple H.
Wow. Well, things are about to heat up, I guess, around here.
My name is Brian Pillman Jr. I am... one third of the New Heart Foundation on Major League Wrestling, and you are listening to
Peezy
on the 2B Blunt Podcast.
That's right, we are back, 2B Blunt Podcast.
Start complaining here. I don't even have. Let me get that Astro over here for a second.
Yeah, of course. Here you go. Take that. You leave that over there. My man.
Well, we got the poll up for the Gas or Trash on Facebook.
That's
make sure
right.
You
thank
sign
you,
up
Frank.
Now and vote.
That's
you can
right.
call in and vote.
Thank you, Frank.
You can
thank
leave
you,
a
Don.
Comment and vote. And I'm going to vote. You want to vote? Let's all vote before we move on. What do you guys think?
I'll vote when I'm ready. All right. God damn it. We'll vote. We still got a lot to do here. The show's still young. You know? Scott's over there in the corner checking his pulse. What are you doing, bro?
I'm checking my pulse, apparently.
Jesus, checking his pulse. Well, I think it's time. It's time that we...
for what we've all been waiting for?
That's right. Get duck.
Oh, I know.
Ladies and gentlemen, the star of the show, our special guest, High Voltage Omar.
Oh, God.
And like I said, mama ain't raised no quitter.
No, she probably wouldn't be.
Oh. Gracias. Gracias.
That's right.
Gracias. Thank you.
Speaking of quitting, you know.
Quitting.
Yeah.
What?
I heard you were stepping away.
Yes. Stepping away. Yes. Yes. Nice choice of words. Yes.
Wow. So just kick it off right with that, huh?
Well, I mean,
I know that's right. Let's start hunting heavy.
Well, I guess we're just
going to start nice and then work our way up. No.
Why not start with the biggest question that, you know, everyone wants to know?
Which is?
You know, people are saying he's retiring, he's quitting. I mean, well, you know, what is he doing?
What are you doing?
I'm taking some me time. My, you know, over the time, I haven't had much me time. My body starts to hurt, my wrist, my knee that's already been injured from Puerto Rico. my rotator cuff. These are like things that's like, all right, I can continue wrestling and then hurt myself and then not be able to do much with my kids. Or I can just step back right now, take some time so I can heal and be with my kids.
That's right.
And enjoy them.
It's perfect.
You know?
That's perfect.
I've been an NYCW champ for 250 days.
Yeah. It's been a while you've been holding that championship.
I've ran through everyone.
That's right.
This year I've done it all.
Not just at the NY. I mean, you make the drives, bro. You make the drives. I've been at enough shows with you, bro.
Look what I did today.
I know.
When you contacted me. Oh, you want to do this over a Skype? Shut the fuck up.
I gave you the option to do Skype. All right.
This insulting.
It is a little insulting, but at the same time,
nobody wants the Skype.
I wanted to give him the option, you know.
Where the fuck?
Listen, this guy drove 2+ hours to come be on the podcast today.
It's worth the memories.
Oh, you're about to be immortalized, bro. For those of you that don't know, we'll put this out there because my throat hurts already.
Yeah.
My God, yo. I need more of that Coquito.
Yeah, follow it down with the Coquito.
Woo. Man. For those of you that don't know, I've known this man for a couple years now. And the first time I met this dude, we clicked because that we were both obviously smokers. And weed brings everybody together. I don't care what anybody says. That's not a lie. Nope. That's the truth.
It's true.
It's damn true.
I've smoked with countless strangers. You know, I've met one time and one time only. Never see him again, but somehow I
smoked the triangle. Connect. Yeah. Taking the walks down the couple blocks to go to the dispensaries and shit before the shows. I've known you for a little bit now. You know?
One, I was like, yo, wait, hold on.
That's right. Yeah, exactly.
Let's go.
So I've known you for a couple years. We've crossed paths in the past at like PWA, which I didn't even realize until I seen pictures of you at PWA that like, I remember seeing you there multiple times at like a Friday night fight.
Yeah. Like I was that guy that would like pop in and out.
Yeah.
I wasn't so much a regular, but when I'd show up, people would be like, oh shit, look who it is.
You look much different then.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. Evolution, baby.
That's
evolution.
Right. It's true.
That's all it is.
But it's real crazy how it worked out, and now here we are, and you're sitting in in our studio here.
And right, I'm honored.
We're going to have this conversation. Absolutely, thank you. Bro. Thank you. Absolutely.
Before, everything gets heated or anything. Thank you.
That's right.
Gracias.
Which we really appreciate, having you here. Because that's going to make the big difference. Man.
Thanks for coming down.
Right. The traffic was worth it.
I hope so.
Dude, I was just chilling. I had the Bloodhound Gang station playing on my
The Bloodhound?
Spotify.
No. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals. Dude, let's do it like we do on the Discovery Channel.
Do it again, though.
Yo, that's that jam.
It was a good time. It was whatever.
Damn, yo.
I was like, hey, 5 minutes. Oh, those 5 minutes just turned into 10. Holy shit, now it's 15? Hey, buddy, I really mean it. 5 minutes this time.
That's right.
Oh, fuck, six. Shit.
You made it in perfect time. You made it. I mean, you were here 10 minutes early. It's perfect. I couldn't ask for more. You're better off than this guy.
Yeah, I was 10 minutes late.
You know, and he's actually a co-host, which is
believe this.
Insane.
Where's HR?
Insane. So, dude, what I don't know about you is, how you got started. We will start off a little nice here, because I honestly have never actually talked to you like this. I don't know where you train. I don't know how long I know how long you've been doing this for, but, it's a lot of things I feel like I don't know. So, please enlighten me.
So, excuse me. It all started when everything was black. Now, what got me into it, or how did I like my first step into wrestling?
Well, where'd you train at?
So, all right, this was in Puerto Rico. I can't even tell you. I would want to say 2007, 2006.
Started training in Puerto Rico?
Yeah.
I didn't fucking know that.
So I went to a local show that they had at a basketball court nearby, indoor little coliseum type thing.
I guess
is what it would translate to. And my buddies, that knew me, whether they were good influences or bad,
they said something to one of the wrestlers, which is the Invader number 3. And he just looks at me. He goes, how old are you? I'm like, oh, I'm 16. I'm about to be 17.
Yeah.
He goes, all right, if you get, you know, consent from your parent, I could train you, or you have to wait till you're 18. And then he gave me his card. And maybe like a month or two later, I called him. And, you know, obviously I was just trying to go around my mother.
Right.
And me and my father never really had a good relationship. So I was like, yeah, let's see what he thinks of this. And he didn't give a shit. Man, my mom was like, whatever, better than me, you know, doing drugs or, you know, running True. The streets, doing, yeah, yeah. you know, bad things.
Right.
So she said it was cool. Then it was a little bit difficult for me to get there. But I started working for the city, and I started working with, it was a recycling center, and I met this one dude who, you know, didn't look like a wrestler, but someone said something about him being a wrestler, and I guess he trained there, and he lived nearby. He goes, yeah, 10 bucks a week, you know, for gas, and I'll bring you up. So we kept going. After the first night, I could barely, like, move my arm, my stiff neck.
And, oh, God, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
Yep.
It is horrible. But yeah, I started training with the Invader number 3, and obviously had a few other, like, teachers down the line. You know how it is. We get different mentors.
Of course. Yeah. Yeah, that's sick, dude.
I don't want to sit here and, like, drop sick. Names.
No, no, no.
No, no need for that.
No, that's just, I just interesting I to know that. You know, because I just, those are things I like to know.
Started in Puerto Rico, yeah. Which is why some people think it's weird that I'm comfortable working the wrong side,
right?
Sometimes yes. at a pinch to get things back to where you got to be.
Mm-hmm.
They say it's wrong. It's I different. Say, hey, it's different.
It's different. I know.
You slice your peanut butter. I mean, you spread your peanut butter with a spoon.
Yeah,
I do it with a butter knife.
Yeah, Pete would always try to, like, teach us both ways.
Yeah, you know, sometimes it happens.
Yeah, and that was it. And that was one of the things he always tried to do. And it was weird at first, you know, trying to, like, yeah, training one way. Don't start like, all right. Now you're going to learn lucha or something, and yeah. we're going to work the other way. And I'm like, yeah, switch arms. It works. It's a completely different, like, thought, like, you know, mind frame.
I was surprised when he let me in. He had Apollo Cruz from Puerto Rico.
Yep.
And Apollo Cruz knew I was here. Leon Apollo, sorry. And he said, you know, come down. And I came down with Fox. And as soon as I got there, you know, Joseph was like, yeah. He goes, get in your gear.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, shit. Like that. He just asked me like 2 questions, and you know,
yeah,
Apollo was just like behind me, and we're like, okay,
yeah,
I like trust him.
I liked my time there, you know, PWA. Cool.
I enjoyed it,
yeah,
I enjoyed it. The fans. Very cool.
So, you go through all this, and now here we are today. You're cutting promos online, you come off bitter, you know, pissed off, annoyed. Total heel shit, which is what I like. I like the heel turn, you know? So how did we get from that to this point now where you are sprinkling salt all over the place?
So I look at the fans and I try to see it as a fan's point of view when I watch wrestling. So, do they want a cartoon character from something back in the 70s and 80s, you know, that is nostalgic? Or do they want something more relatable? I like something more relatable. I like Austin's attitude. I like Jericho's wit. I like how The Miz was a fucking complete jerk. It was like, you just mesh all of those. And I was like, yeah, they could just be pretty much me. I like bitter of already, like, of life, of being held back, so it's like I don't ask for things anymore. I just go and I just get it. I want it, I get it. I said I was getting that championship, I got it. I said I was gonna be the forever champ. I've been champ since March.
It's true.
No one has beaten me for it.
Now here it is right in the studio.
It's right there, you know? Chilling on the couch.
That's it.
Relaxing in the lounge.
But now you got the title back. You feel great about it.
That's right.
But still...
Where was the title? What do you mean, back?
What?
What do you mean, back? He's been the champ for 284 days.
Right.
Was it stolen, or you were not the champ? Or...
Yep, it was stolen from me.
There you go.
Wow.
It was stolen.
Stolen.
Yep. stolen. I traveled all New York searching for Wayno through all the golf courses. And every time he was ahead of me, man. He just got away. And then right at the last show, last Saturday, he had nowhere to go. I defeated his boys. You know, they got DQ'd because they couldn't, you know, get past me. And obviously, Wayno had a cheat. I was going to play a fair game as long as he did. But, you know, I thought the ref would have just restarted the match, but he just reversed the decision.
All right. So now you got it back. You got it back.
All right, so got the title back.
Got it back.
But here's the thing. Before we got off the tangent, you got the title back. Everything's full circle, but now you still are giving it back.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, you said you're stepping away.
Yeah, it's coming with me, though.
So you're just taking this you're just going to be like, fuck this shit. I'm taking this bitch home.
Do not understand the hashtag forever champ. Okay. That means more to me because they, the fans, say it. So when I step away, if I don't lose in December, it's coming home with me. And they can wait till I'm ready. And then maybe, just maybe, I'll sit and I'll watch the tapes and I'll decide if someone is worthy. Till then, they have a mid-card belt and a tag team division they can focus on.
So you're just, he's just taking the belt and going home, goddammit.
That's right.
That's it.
Wow.
That's it.
It's that easy, huh? Well, I see it. I see it right the there office on the knows couch. It. About to take a go. There's three of us, man. One hand, what do you say?
That's it. You know what? We can split it in thirds.
Podcast belt.
We'll give Scott a side plate. You all know? Right. Or like just a strap.
Wait till the Coquito hits you guys.
That's right, that is Suplex City.
We're going to stand up, probably fall right down.
That's right. So now you've reached the end of your time. You're taking time away. And like I said, you're coming off bitter, angry, you know, salty, some might say. What makes you sick about the wrestling business that you've been cutting these promos, you know? Because we've been talking now for, it's been over a month now since we planned on doing this. And at that point, you were like, I'm ready. You were all fired
yeah,
up.
Yeah, dude. Oh.
You were all fired
rough
up.
Rough times.
So
man.
I gotta know.
I'm still there. I'm just not that fired up.
I just gotta know what the fuck's going on. You know?
I'm just like, sick what is, of what I'm seeing. Not really in a lack of product, but lack of caring in what they do. Everyone does the same shit. They're either all wearing black, coming out to fucking metal, wanting to be some dark fucking cool guy. Or they're all bright colors. Hey, come on, high fives. I'm sick of that shit. And then it's like you got guys that don't completely commit. And I got one. I said, no holding back. And, you know, no heat. I actually said something nice to him the other day. He had a nice jacket, but whatever. So fuck him. But.
Wow.
But his gimmick name, and if this draws him attention, it does. And if it doesn't, it doesn't. Danny Adam. It's like his character. Is some wastelander, yet he's wearing a satanic coat, and he's got a gas mask on, doesn't have a deep voice or a voice of a survivor, and then he fucking wears glasses in his promos, and it's like, do you fucking wear those to wrestle? No, then why are you wearing them? Like, separate that shit from then, you know, who the wrestler who you are, who the story you're trying to sell, because right now I'm not fucking buying shit other than his, you know, he's doing good in the ring. I'm not going to take that away from him.
In his defense, but, all right, what you were talking about having a deep voice, but if I could reference one person who had a mask and did not have a deep voice, that was Bane.
Yeah, right, but
big ass dude. Hello, Batman.
I guess, but it's just... Oh, it just doesn't.
I know.
I
felt the same way about the. But that's how I felt about the movie. When you see Bane in real life, he's this giant ass dude. It looks like he just destroy you. He's like, hello, Batman.
Yeah, but that made the movie for me. Like, if he had a deep voice.
Dude, I don't know. It seemed weird, bro.
That was.
It threw me off.
And I loved it.
But I agree with you about the glasses thing, for example. Like, the douche, that should be a conscious decision to not, you know, obviously.
You wear glasses.
Yes. You ever seen a promo where I'm wearing one?
No.
No matter if I can't see shit. And most of the time I can't.
It's just like, you just gotta commit to it. Like, I'm a jerk, so I still give people shit when they come up to me wanting photos and they want to buy my stuff. I yell at them. I tell them. They walk right by me. I was like, hey, you can literally wear this shirt to do whatever. You gotta do laundry? Wear this shirt. You gotta, you know, go food shopping? You could wear the shirt. Go quickly to the cemetery? Boom. You need a shirt? Wear my shirt. You need something to put on the floor, you know, when you come out taking a shower? Boom, my shirt. Just buy it.
True. Absolutely.
Kids want pictures. I'm like, ugh. But, you know.
Yeah. At the end of the day, I'll give them the cameras, per se, quote unquote, stop rolling, you still, you know, if as long as you're still in the venue and in front of the audience, you withhold the gimmick. Or not withhold, yeah. That's not even the right word. You actually just, you still keep,
no,
you know.
No one cares. It's like, as soon as their match is over, you got them sitting in the audience right there watching. It's like, what the hell are you doing?
I've seen.
Like, whatever happened to just sitting in the back?
Yeah, I've seen guys doing that at Battlefront.
Sorry, you don't got a way to watch.
Yeah.
Why the hell are you circling around and sitting in the audience right after you just got your ass beat or whatever?
I don't agree that they should be doing that. I'm with you. I never understood that.
Unless you got a merch table and you're sitting there all beat up, whatever. But in the audience.
And then like they'll go change and just walk back out there. Yeah, no one's going to recognize them. Like, bro, you look like Superman as much as Clark Kent does, bro.
Yeah,
it's
like, come on.
I hear you. I hear you. You know?
It's like, who's training these people?
Although I could definitely say that I was definitely out there for like 2 seconds to see this barbed wire shit. And then I was like, nope, I can't do this.
I wouldn't even want to watch it. No.
I tried. It literally took 2 seconds, bro.
What?
They like hit him with a board that had mouse traps on it. And I was like, I'm done. I'm fucking done.
Nope.
I was like, I can't do this.
Bye.
I can't do this. So you got the guys backstage not living the gimmick. And then you got backstage drama. You know?
Oh, entitled people, bro. Yes. Whether it's like who trained them or, oh, I'm better than this guy or I'm better than that or why am I not in that position? I'm like, bro, chill. This is the promoter's story. If he just doesn't see you in that role, he doesn't see you in it. If he's got you in, you're just beginning. Take your fucking matches. Earn your shit. Get your little spots. Work on your shit. On your craft, not your shit. And, you know, and then, you know, if the crowd reacts to you in certain ways, you know, you start doing better, you try contributing.
Yeah, but that doesn't always happen.
Exactly. But you got those guys that want to, you know, walk in, oh, I'm big and bad, blah, 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 I can't be defeated. Like, okay, who said that?
Isn't that what Pac said to AEW? Scott.
Maybe.
I thought that was the whole thing.
Like, go back to being the 1-2-3 kid.
Yeah, that's why he didn't do the original match with Hangman.
Oh, I guess so.
And they ended up doing it overseas because whatever. What was it? Dragon Gate.
Yeah.
They won't let. Like, they don't want him losing the belt. And then he told the AEW they won't. He won't lose to Hangman.
You're saying like people backstage will be like based on who trained them, they'll think if they're better than somebody else.
Yeah,
in their head.
What they've done.
Ow, fuck, man. Jesus Christ. Jesus, sorry. Good. Yeah, just smash ready. We're good. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So, when you trained in Puerto Rico, and then what? You moved up to the Northeast. How long did you wrestle in Puerto Rico for?
I wrestled in Puerto Rico for 3.5 years.
Three and a half years.
I worked up in IWA. I worked in WCW. I mean, yeah, WWC.
WWC.
Yeah, WWC.
Well, Wrestling Council, I believe.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yeah. That's right, man. You know, Carlitos. And
yeah.
Shit. I was going to say, yeah, the Colognes, right? Yeah.
Yep.
The fucking Sky. It's like he was there with his Ribera
jacket. I didn't know IWA was down there, though.
Looking for a steak.
Back in the day, now they got one back in Puerto Rico and one in Florida.
Okay. Now, I've never been to Puerto Rico, but I assume you did a lot of maybe outdoor matches, no?
Oh, yes. Yes, yeah. Dude. It is an amazing experience, dude.
Yeah. And you, like, really, you can be really
right
hot.
Outside of buildings. Oh, dude, right in a flea market.
Oh, yeah.
Noon.
Dude, and I'm guessing it's like 100 degrees.
Crispy, dude.
And I'm guessing that mat is like,
yeah. Oh,
if you're standing too long on your back, you probably have to like get up immediately, I bet.
Horrible. And then, you know, you get mad when you're working for the guys who got a black canvas because that's just holding heat.
Sounds like the Scott's been in a ring before over here. He's
worked in the ring. It's crazy, man. It's man, everywhere.
A black
like,
canvas, though. That's outside. That's kind of...
Yeah, man. I'm stuff. Talking about, like, behind bars, outside, like, political, like, buildings where they have, like, their little rally parties. Sometimes they'll, you know, rent out the company or whatever or buy the event, and we just come in. We do the show there. We've been in front of what we would have here called bakeries, and people are just getting drunk outside watching this shit. And every time you have a hardcore match, because that's just Puerto Rico, and drunk yeah. fans love it, and that's just what it is. And it's always the old timers that'll do it.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, and those fans are animals, man. So since I knew English, they were like, "All right, we're gonna play you off as an American."
Right.
But it was the whole, like, New Yorican, so I was like, oh, I'm better than you.
Yeah.
Because I accept English, I accept the culture, blah, blah, blah. And then right. I'd just wave around the American flag, and I'd speak English, and they're like, ah, estamos en Puerto Rico, habla español. I'd call them cucarachas, you know, which
yeah, oh, my God, shit. Yes.
You know, because oh they don't accept God. It. I was like, you guys want to be independent, but you can't even support yourself without food stamps. America! I love you guys.
Wow. That's amazing. I see. That's pretty sick. The Scott, only the Scott would be bringing up the outdoor gimmicks, you know?
Oh, yeah, dude.
I don't know. I think about Puerto Rico and I think about the
fields,
lovely weather.
People's like backyards.
What?
Oh, yeah. They'll like block parties.
Man.
Oh, man.
Scott's out here killing it.
What was that? Was that Stump the Scott?
No. No, so, dude, you had a big Q&A the other night, and you had a lot to say. I watched the Q&A that you did last week.
Yeah.
That's right. And, again, you were, you had, dude, did you see it, Frank?
Yeah, I'm the one who told you about it.
That's right. Shout out the podcast.
Yeah. Like, this is going to be no holds bar. This is going to be the Coquito podcast. You said no holding back.
No holding back, baby.
Because you're just not asking the right questions, man.
What do you mean?
You know, it must. What do you mean? You gotta ask
I'm not
right,
asking the right
you
question.
You got to fire him up.
You're asking the right question, Frank.
I don't know, man. Do you have any like legitimate beef with anyone in the wrestling business? Like any promoters or anything that you want to air your side of the story that people think, oh, HBO is a dick, but you're really not a dick, and you want to just shed light on anything, just feel free. I mean, but Scott's got questions for days, too.
I wrote some stuff down, yeah.
Hey, damn, he's got the list.
Damn, Scott. Oh.
The two
I'm not sure. All right, so it's like let me see.
Oh no, he's clamming up.
No, man, you got 12 years, whatnot, right? Doing this, and everyone's always they get jealous. Oh, someone doesn't belong in certain spots, or why am me? Let's say NYCW. I never thought I would have been the first champ. I figured, you know, I was one of the top guys, but not ego-wise, just of what I saw in the locker room.
Right.
And that was, I don't want to say one of the first times I started feeling, like, uncomfortable, where I started, like, sizing people up, where I was like, I wanted to watch all of these guys. And I did. And a lot of them, you know, hyped me up. I felt, like, good, you know, because I was already getting to a point in life where I did want to step away from wrestling just completely. It was destroying, you know, my life. And I figured if this is bringing down, let's say, like my marriage, I'm just going to stop. And then not even 2 weeks down the line, everything's okay. I'm good to go. Whatever. I start doing it. a buddy of mine, Ronnie Ribs, who, you know, thinks he's like fucking hot shit. Love the guy. Love someone who has confidence in themselves, but there's just so much I can take where it's like, shut the fuck up. You ain't shit. You know, he's very old school. He's very, he's all right. Like, I wouldn't be excited about having a singles match with him whatsoever. You know, likes to talk shit. And it's cool. You know, we're online. You never know how to read someone's fucking comment. You just read it. You just go by it. Oh, you're retiring. Oh, you want fucking like sympathy. This is your way of like trying to get fans. And I'm like, bro, like shut the fuck up. Right? This was the whole thing. Oh, he goes, oh, you know, I'm just fucking with you, blah, 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 blah. I was like, yeah, okay, why you're like getting upset about it? I'm just fucking responding. You're talking to me on my fucking gimmick page. I'm gonna fucking respond to you as I would, but it's my page, so I will comment the way I want. He doesn't like it. Whatever. We don't really talk, see each other like down the lines, whatever. I had made the post on Facebook officially, you know, end of the year, I'm taking my fucking time off, I'm done, you know. I can't stand the people who, you know, they're just jealous of someone instead of just being happy and understanding that it's the promoter's vision. And if you're not in that vision and the fans don't give a fuck about you, then why would they want to use you? Don't cry about not having that spot if you're not creating it.
Man.
And then he, you know, wants to go on there. Wants to talk shit. I just give him the little middle finger emoji and he gets all sensitive about it, goes and makes a post on Facebook and can't even fucking tag me in it.
Oh, no.
I'm like, bro, is it really that fucking serious? Like, what are you upset at? I just took food off, you know, I just put food on your table. I'm not on the fucking market right now. You got more fucking opportunities. What the fuck are you complaining about?
So you're saying that was directed at you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He could fucking deny it, but that shit was directed at me. He could have been man enough. You know, he wants to be man enough and post it. He wants to be the big tough guy. Can't even fucking tag me in it. It's like, bro, you're really that fucking upset? Like, you're giving me shit. I'm giving you shit. Why can't you fucking, you know, you can't keep the banter going. Don't fucking go on your page. Oh, I unfriended him, blah, 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 whatever the fuck you had to say. Yeah, because yeah. I really didn't care about it.
Yeah, that's fucked up. Don't take to your own personal page and yeah. talk shit and not say what you wanted to say. Even though it's, you know, it's social media. Everyone likes to move their fingers. Start typing away.
Twitter fingers?
Bullshit. Yeah, it's like, bro, just tag me.
Peter knows about that. You know, he's got heat on Facebook.
Like, bro, I'm off the market. That's more shit for you right there. That should be you sliding your foot in the door.
Yeah, you should be getting hungry, but, I mean.
You want it or you fucking want it?
I don't know who this guy is. Like, what'd you say his name was? Ronnie?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, you've seen him at shows before.
What's his name?
Ronnie Ribs.
Maybe if I seen him, I would know.
Oh, he just needs to be a bit more humble.
Well,
it's like people always ask me. It's like, dude, I'm just come in. I do what the fuck I'm told. Get my envelope. Chill with the boys, Batman. Drive back home, back to my real life.
That's it. Least favorite promoter. Beef.
Oh, Dan Gore, like Battlefront, man.
Oh, no.
Dude, it's like I kind of like the guy, but as a promoter, man, it's just I just can't, man. He likes to change shit the last minute. It makes no fucking sense. It's like what the fuck is going on?
Wow. Last time I was at Battlefront on Saturday, I found a little card of yours.
4 days ago.
Had your picture on it. It was like a little card, bro. And it had you in your pose. And it was like high voltage.
Like a baseball card?
Oh, shit.
It was sitting behind the TV.
What the fuck is this?
It's fucking
this. Has the guy's booking number on it? It's got your booking number on it?
Yo, what edition is that shit? I wish I kept it.
I think that was first. Ah, you should have. Should have fucking kept it. I don't think I got anything on me.
Damn.
Ah, you missed out. It was a fucking first edition.
I put it back so I made sure you felt like you were in the locker room.
Yeah, there you go.
Even though I know you didn't want to be there.
Apparently not. Least favorite promoter.
No, I would never want to guess that. I'd put myself up for that one. Damn.
So who's the favorite promoter then in this case?
Damn.
It's easy to remember the bad ones, right?
Yeah, man. It's like... Shit. There's like two, but it's like, I can't really pick because it's like they've both given me the same thing. They've given me the freedom that I would want with my character to go, which way I feel the crowd is going with me.
Well, if you got two, you know.
It could be a tie. We got room for
two. Scott always gives two answers when he doesn't know the answer.
True.
It has to be, well, then Scott Fellows from TIW, Truly Independent Wrestling from Pittsfield, Massachusetts.
Of course. I know. I've heard of them before.
The unknown owner of NYCW, who, you know, asked me, what did I want? And I'm like, I'm just going to go out there and do what I do and see how they feel about me. And then that's how I'll react to them.
Wow.
I'm all about giving them what they want, whether they like or they hate me. They're still chanting my name.
So you're the people's champ.
He is.
The people. He's a champion for the people.
The people's forever champ.
That's right. I don't know.
Well, we'll see if he walks out of here tonight with it, guys.
Why? You got to get the pin, bro? Man.
So that was promoters. But as far as workers, who is... I'm going to go with favorite first this time. Who is your favorite person to work with?
Where?
Anywhere. In your entire career.
That's also two.
If it's easier to do the least favorite first, you can do that.
No, it's like two just because one reminds me of the other. So in Puerto Rico, I had my cousin who, after a while, me, you know, going down the line, just pretty much being a stale wrestler, picked me up and we were talking and ended up finding out that we were, you know, like second or third cousins, whatever. And, you know, he took me under his wing and got me into more of a lucha style and more of a cruiserweight wrestling, which is what they like in Puerto Rico.
Right.
With some strong style. And out here, it's been like with Fox, because Fox always has a whole bunch of ideas and he's always like all over the place. So sometimes it's also like, shut the fuck up, like calm down, because now you already lost me because you're over here, but now you're over there. And it's like, it's fun because it's like you never know. But it's like, I know him well enough that TIW, we have a match this Friday, this Saturday, and I'm excited about it. Whether win or lose, I'm excited about it because I know it's going to be a well put together like match,
right?
Like from beginning to end.
Yeah,
it's like very little I get excited about matches nowadays, you know.
Damn, you're at that point
now?
It's
not go big or go home. It's I'm going home, so go big. Yeah, I don't know how long it'll be. It could be a month, two, three, 4 months, five. Maybe I won't be back for a couple years. Who knows? No one knows.
Well, now that we got your favorite, though, who's your least favorite?
Oof. Kirby Wackerman. Great guy, never but
Kirby Wackerman.
It's not Ronnie. No.
No. I'd rather wrestle Ronnie than wrestle Kirby. I had to wrestle him in a main event match, and guy could barely put together a popcorn match.
I mean, his name's Kirby.
Yeah, no, so Ronnie at least could work.
Yeah,
Ronnie can at least work.
By the way, disclaimer, these are all the opinions of one high voltage Omar, myself.
It's like one of those matches where I go like old school, where it's like, all right, beginning, middle, end, you want something, all right, I want something, all right, the rest we'll talk up there, and then the dude's just quiet and just going off what we said. I'm like, oh, okay, this is what we're doing.
Instead of talking their way through.
Yeah, so yeah. It's like, all right, so let's just fucking go home, I guess. No connection, quick, yo, let's do this, that, no, nothing. I'm like, oh, man, this is not a main event match. And then I go to the back, and so it's like, oh, good match, Omar. And I'm like, yeah, don't fucking lie to me. I've said it to many people.
I know it was
people.
The shits.
I've said it to many people. I was like, yeah, don't fucking lie to me, please. Like, let's not do this.
Oh, no.
I know, that wasn't good.
Wackerman, you suck.
Did you get, like, pissed off and just stiff the fuck out of him in the match, or?
No, I kept it civil, you know.
Have you ever gotten pissed off and just purposely stiff someone right to hell?
Oh, yes.
If so, yes. Who was it and why?
Oh, shit.
Why did that fucker get his fucking head clocked off by HVO?
Frank's and did you initiate it? Or was it
was once. It was in a battle royal. It was quick. It was... Yo. It was a dick move, but he's a dick, and it's a dick lane, and I just couldn't stand his shit. He was, like, wearing a Deadpool clothing, but he had, like, Wolverine chops and a fucking...
Was this Danny Adam?
No, Dick Lane.
Come on.
Dick Lane?
I don't know.
Dick Lane. He had, like, the Deadpool, like, jumpsuit, and he had the Wolverine chops, but he had, like, a headband, and... I was like, what the fuck is going on? And so he just got a quick forearm, bam, and I just kept working around. I was like, all right, I'm good now.
So you just gave him a quick stiff one?
Yeah, quick stiff him, walked around, all right. Let's play nice on this corner.
That's right, float like a butterfly, exactly. Sting like a bee.
And then that was the first and the end of it.
Wow. Who would have thought? I'd never even heard of these guys. Dick Lane, Kyle Wackerman, Kirby Wackerman.
It's a lot of, you know... It's a lot of people, man, in independent wrestling.
I guess so.
And sometimes it happens, but... It's like, what is it? A tag match I had with Tyshine and, like, Rhode Island against the Middlesex Express. Got stiff the fuck up. I was like, oh, shit. All right, boom. When it was my turn, boom, boom. And I was like, oh, man, I kind of feel like a dick. All right, Ty, your turn.
It's always guaranteed to give a receipt or what? Is that standard?
It's standard, yeah.
It's standard, but I'm not that guy. Boom, some shit happens. Yeah. You know?
I don't feel
it's intentional. Something happens, boom, all right, you came in too hard on a tackle, boom, whatever, I'll sell your strength. But if I saw you come in and you fucking throw it in your shoulder, okay.
Because I see some guys that just work stiff every match.
Yeah, bro.
And it's like, at what point does the other guy decide to just, like, give him a receipt? And then at that point, it's just like, receipt, bro, some dudes, receipt, yeah. Receipt, receipt.
Yeah, it's not just, fun, bro. You get to the point where it's back and forth. Yeah. It's not like, all right, this is your boy. We could go a little hard. No, this is like, yo, we're about to fucking stop and go.
Go outside?
Fuck out this ring.
Let's not even get outside.
Line. I've seen dudes get all fired up before, you know, just going to Battlefront shows with you. Storming out, you know, sitting outside all quiet, whining.
Listen, I know what you're talking
about. It happens.
It's a man sport.
Yeah.
It is a man sport. Wrestling is not for the weak, you know? If you got an ego,
whatever, it's cool.
Yeah.
Show the fuck out.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Unless the guy's staring at you at the end of the room, drilling you afterwards, and doesn't want to talk to you, then just chill the fuck out.
Right. Well, if you had one last thing to say to, you know, I don't know if you want to call your haters, your followers, I don't know. I mean, I just want to, if you had one last thing you need to get off your chest or one thing that people need to know or that we maybe didn't cover that you thought was vital to your story, what would that be?
My motivation to do me, the best me. Because at the end of the day, you still have haters. And at the end of the day, you just got to shove your middle finger in their face and say, hey, I'm still going to fucking do me.
That's it.
It's like I tell people, you know, they get ridiculous when they go to take their selfie, right? Someone goes to walk by. Oh, they put their phone down. The fuck up. Put your phone up. Take your selfie. You want it? Take your selfie. That's me in life. I want it. I'm just going to take it. And then you get people, you know, that, like I said, that they just complain about shit, you know. Oh, why are you this? Why are you that? And then I just got to get in their face about it.
Damn.
If you ain't going to fucking take it, I'm going to fucking take it.
That's right. And if I want to take a step away, that's what I'm going to do.
That's right.
That's it.
You got a problem with it, hit me up. Call right now.
That's right.
Tell me why you got a problem with it.
You could. You could.
Unretired. Who the fuck are you to tell me?
So far, we only had Jeremy.
Jeremy. He's persistent.
I think Jeremy's got his fingers on the phone right now. I think
have there been any comments, any questions on the from the Facebook?
Nope.
All right.
Some people just, you know, chiming in, HVO, HVO.
Nice. Oh, nice. That's
because they
is.
Know I live in a 3-foot radius. If it doesn't affect my life, I don't give a fuck about it.
Yeah.
You know, it ain't paying my bills. It ain't keeping me fed.
Yeah, some people don't separate the wrestling life.
Right. Yeah. You know.
You have to.
Well, let me ask you a question. We talked about a lot of things. How would you feel about trying to stump the Scott?
Well, I got one as a joke one because it's an obvious one, but everyone should be able to figure
guys
that out.
Guys think we should play a little stump the Scott?
I got some questions.
Wait, hopefully I get it. I don't know. My track record's not that great.
Do you have any questions, PC?
I don't know. We'll find out. So we're going to play Stump the Scott.
He's the smartest.
You don't have any brains. I'm from Hollywood. I have the brains.
He's unstoppable.
Nobody in the whole world can beat me one-on-one right now.
It's the hottest game show around. It's Stump the Scott. And now, your host, Bud Griffin.
That's right. We're back for another edition of Stump the Scott. In studio, we have special guest High Voltage Omar. I'm Bud Griffin, and we're going to play Stump the Scott right here. So coming up first with question number one, we're going to give it to our special guest. He is the most electrifying man in sports entertainment. He is High Voltage Omar.
Thank you for having me here today. All right, my first question is, what is the only title that the WWE lets Kofi Kingston hold for more than a few short months?
Scott, 30 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now.
I mean, you have the decipher, I guess, a few short months. But anyway, Bud, it's good to see you.
Thank you, Scott.
Hi, Voltage Omar. Glad you could be here today. Frank Knox, always Scott, a pleasure.
Always.
So, I mean, it was more than a few months because he won it this year at WrestleMania. So I'm just going to say the WWE Championship. I mean, he held it from April 7th to October 4th of this year, 2019.
That's a few months?
That's like more than almost six. Almost six. It's almost 6 months.
Is he correct or incorrect?
That wasn't where I was going with it, but...
I don't think the tag...
I was going with the tag team titles.
No!
You know what? You know what? He's right.
Tag team titles.
I was thinking current.
No, he's right.
No, but he's right. They did held... He did... With the
was like a full year or whatever.
Scott, already the first one.
They held a tag team title for over 400 days.
Well, Scott, we have to.
Anyway.
We got a rebuttal.
Sorry. Maybe I've had too much to drink. All right.
This has happened to everything. We talk about this all the time. This guy.
I think he gets contact time.
I think what happens is the Scott claims to be the smartest and then drinks out of tree houses, and it clearly is not the smartest. Bud Griffin here, and we're about to play Stump the Scott. Frank Knox, you're up.
Scott, all of these men won the WWE World Heavyweight Championship for the first time during a 90s Survivor Series, except, and the choices are, Psycho Sid, The Rock, The Big Show, or Triple H.
Would you like him to repeat the question, Scott?
No, actually I don't.
30 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now.
Because The Rock won it at Survivor Series 1998. Psycho Sid won it at Survivor Series 1996. Big Show won it at Survivor Series 1999. So the correct answer would be Triple H, who won it on a Raw the night after SummerSlam 1999.
Wow! The Scott answered the whole question with details. He's correct!
I know, extra credit, right? Come on.
The Scott, you've done it. You finally finished the question in less than 30 seconds with the right answer today. All right. Well, guys, I guess it's my turn. Bud Griffin here, and we're about to play Stump the Scott. Scott, are you ready for your third question?
I'm ready.
Frank, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Electrifying Man, are you ready?
Estoy listo.
I think that means I'm ready.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Scott. Who held the WWF title for a total of 2 minutes and 7 seconds? I repeat, who held the WWF title for a total of 2 minutes and 7 seconds? Your options are Bret Hart, Kane, Hulk Hogan and Yokozuna. 30 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now.
So before you said those choices,
he was screwed.
Yokozuna first came to my head. I was thinking WrestleMania 9 when he beat Bret Hart and then lost it to Hulk Hogan. You said Hogan was a choice. I don't remember him having that short of a reign. The other two names, I don't even remember what you said. So I'm just gonna stick with Yokozuna because that was my gut before you did multiple choices. So I'm gonna say Yokozuna. Final answer.
Well, Scott is right again. He is now 2 correct and 1 incorrect answer. High Voltage. Do you have another question for the Scott?
Yeah, but it's not as in detailed.
That's all right. Bring it on.
The Scott says to bring it on. Let's find out if High Voltage Omar can do the impossible and stop the Scott.
All right. In 96, who did the New Age Outlaws defeat to win the tag team titles?
30 seconds on the clock, and your time starts now.
All right, so it's a trick question, because if you look it up, the correct answer is no one, because it was really, if you're trying to ask the question, it was 1997, and the New Age Outlaws defeated the Legion of Doom. It was 97, not 96. So,
whoa!
Depending on how you ask the question.
We had a fact check?
Yes, it was 97 when the New Age Outlaws won the first tag team titles from the Legion of Doom. It was not 96.
Well, they weren't formed until 97, so...
So, come on, they didn't even exist in 96. Come on.
Scott, you are on fucking fire right now. 3-1. We might as well take one more question, and Frank, what do you say?
All right, let's do it.
Frank Knox is ready. Are you ready to play Stump the Scott?
I mean, he wasn't even rockabilly yet in 97.
What name did Jim the Anvil Neidhart go as under the Masked Wrestler?
Who?
There you go.
Who's on first? What's on second? What? You don't even have to play the music. It's who.
You got it right. Who?
Oh, this is my night tonight. I can feel it.
That was insane. Jim the Anvil Neidhart came out to a yellow mask and went by the name of who?
Well, I guess the Sky has won. He's back. The Sky, you got 4 questions out of 5 correct.
This is why I signed the contract to the show, by the way.
Oh, wow. I can't believe this guy. He's up.
He's done it.
He's up.
He's done it. The boyhood dream.
The boyhood dream is back. It's going to come true. Well, I'm really impressed. I mean, I feel like maybe this is on the way to go. Maybe you're on the up and up.
Maybe. Do I have one more question?
No, you don't.
Oh, okay.
You want one more? I mean,
I thought he had one more. You did 2. Didn't you do 2? I thought he was going to do 2.
There's no need. You already are. You clearly won.
We usually do 6 questions every time.
Doesn't matter.
Oh, somebody give me a Survivor Series question off the top of your head. Come on.
Hey, yo, it's HBO, High Voltage Omar. You are listening to the top podcast around, To Be Blunt, with your host, Peezy.
Another episode of To Be Blunt.
We had technical difficulties, but PZ asked me who was the troubleshooting referee at the Survivor Series 94 casket match.
I did not ask
between Undertaker and Yokozuna.
I did not ask you any such thing. Chuck
Norris, Walker Texas Ranger himself, Chuck Norris, is the answer to that question, by the way. So I get one more correct answer. Thank you.
Okay.
One more on the board.
Wow.
Scott is he's hijacking the show with this, his trivia. And he asked himself the question. Nobody even asked him that question.
I know. Well, Frank, let me ask you a question. Do we have anyone from Voted for DOS?
Well, I will check it out.
We need to know the results. I mean, it's already at the end of the show here.
We're going to find out right now.
I want to know. Did the audience think you had how many?
3 votes.
Just 3?
Yeah. It was 60, so we got 4 votes.
Where is it?
Somebody stuck in.
We got 4 votes. It's a tie.
Oh, there it
50,
is.
50-50.
The tie.
Tie. Somebody's got to, like,
oh boy,
break the tie right now.
Oh, my God. We're at a tie. Okay. Well, we're at a tie. What do you want? I guess, do we call that a win?
Tie goes to the runner?
I mean, usually.
Yeah, Omar, what'd you think? You were shooting all day. Is it gas or trash?
I'll give it the gas. Why not?
Give it the gas.
I guess
there
that's it.
There it is.
Congratulations, Taz.
Congratulations, it's a win.
We're going to feature on the website. We'll embed your SoundCloud player right on the front page.
That's right.
We'll give you a little free promo. Until next week, 2 Be Blunt Podcast. Make sure you review and subscribe to our podcast. Add us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at 2 Be Blunt Podcast with the number 2. That's right. I am your host, Peezy. In studio, Frank Knox, the Scott High Voltage Omar. We'll see you next week on the 2 Be Blunt Podcast.
The hippie, Dickie Moon, man. It's time to sit back, relax, and chill. You're tuned into the 2 Be Blunt Podcast with Frank Knox and Peezy.
Peace!
Oh boy, that's a long list. Luckily, holiday scratch tickets are the perfect gift for everyone in your life. Like your husband who binge-watched the next 3 episodes without you. You know who you are. Or your parents and your new sibling?
Give your sister a kiss.
Yikes. Spoil the ones you love this holiday season with scratch tickets from the Connecticut Lottery. Use your game sense. Odds vary by and during games. Must be 18 or older to purchase. Lottery tickets are not suitable gifts for children under 18 years of age. CTLottery.org. Everyone on your holiday list deserves the perfect gift. Why? Because deep down, you love them. Like that couple who's super excited about their new baby.
Isn't he just the cutest?
Or your coworker who's a loud talker.
Mondays, am I right?
Yeah, even him. Spoil the ones you love this holiday with scratch tickets from the Connecticut Lottery. Use your game sense. Odds vary by and during games. Must be 18 or older to purchase. Lottery tickets are not suitable gifts for children under 18 years of age. CTLottery.org.